Yeah, today I'm going to tie my version of Oliver Edwards' famous Betis nymph. Just to tell you a wee bit about Betis nymphs, they're a part of the Ephemeroptera family, the Agilidata group of the Ephemeroptera family. Agilidata nymphs are small, streamlined, fast swimming nymphs. So I think when you tie this fly, you want it, the secret is to get it nice and thin, streamlined, just like a natural. So the hook I'm using today is a long shank, slightly long shank nymph hook. And the thread is the usual uni-tricoat. So first thing, on my rough layer of thread. Bring it down before it starts, just before the bend. And then for the tails, all I've got is just simple 3 dyed olive pheasant tail strands. Just make sure they're lined up and just tie them in, pinch and loop. And then the length you want. You want it maybe about the length of the abdomen and the nymph's going to be maybe. I know the longest tail's on a base. Maybe there's fine maybe. And a couple of turns just to tie it down. And then what I do there is nail underneath it. And that just splays the tails. Don't know if you can see that there. And then I do one wrap under the faraway one, and then one wrap under that one. What that does is just separates and sits them like that. So then what I do is just touch and turns, catch that pheasant tail in. The thorax here is going to be dubbed, so you can just cut up in there. Bring the thread back down. Once I get to where about the abdomen is going to end, I start to build up the thread a wee bit. What this does is just try and create a taper back down to the where you're going to tie in your body material. Try and keep your thread wraps minimum away from the bottom. So then bring it to there and I'm ready to tie in your body material. And for the body, I've got a piece of clear flexi body. Cut a slight angle on it just to let you tie it in. Maybe cut a wee bit more on that. Just sit that on top. Thread's playing up. The idea is just try and slide it all back just till you've just got the point in that and no more. And then a couple of nice tight wraps. Then back up again. You want to just try and keep that nice taper on the body. And then what I've got is an olive pro marker. I just colour the top of that. Top of the thread olive. So then you're ready to rub the body. So first turn, just pull it a wee bit tight. Then slightly overlapping wraps, maybe a bit, about half and half of what the width for the flexor body is when you're overlapping. And again, I don't want to be letting go at this point. And just tie that off nice and tight. Then what I do is usually bring that body, flexor body, back just to secure it. Snip it off. A wee bit closer. Cut them up, nice tight thread wraps. And I hope you can see that nice lymphy body. Now you're ready. Bit of dubbing for the thorax. The dubbing I'm using is Wapsy super fine dry fried dubbing, nice and slim. Because one nice and slim, again you can put on loads of layers and you hardly get any build up. Because you've got flexible body going on to be a hook shank, you want to build that head up just to create the same level. Slip up back in the where the abdomen ends. A bit thin that. I don't want to go too close to the head. I want you to go there. Just a couple of turns just to tie off that dubbin. And just tidy up. Then what I do is, because this thread's very thin, you just bring it back through the dubbin and you hardly see it. So then, what I do is leave my thread hanging just at the end of the dubbing there. Then what I've got, say, some olive rubber leg material. And I think this could make a break your fly, I think, getting these perfect. Spending a wee bit of time getting them perfect really does the difference. So the first one, what I do is bring that thread slip to it. Make a couple of turns with you on your first set of legs to be. Then bring that underneath your thread. Set that where you'd like it to be. And then another piece for this side. Bring it up on the thread. Okay, just set that where you'd like it to be. And you want it right on the side of the hook shank or the body or whatever. Once you're happy with what I do then is I cut my tight turns. So that's your first set of leg done. Cut with nice tight turns. And then I just go ahead and snip off the waist piece of it. As close as you can get it. Put a slight stretch in there, you can get it really close. And I cut my turns. So then If you think your legs are not sitting right, see if you now be tidy bit of dubbing. A wee whiskey dubbing. Again, just put it in behind the legs. What this does is just sets it right, sets the legs out right. So if you drag your two legs forward, looks already there. The rest of it doesn't. And then circle your thread forward to where you want your next set of legs to be. Again, a few couple of turns. Our piece of leg. Bring it over the thread and onto the side of the body. Another piece over the thread around this side of the body and check if you've got it sitting right. Then up a couple of nice tight turns. You could even do a couple of turns in behind the leg just to splay it out and sit it nice. Happy with that. Snip off the waist. Snip off the waist on this side. Put the more tight turns. Then circle forward. Over here, what I like to do is really tight and quite hard and create a pronotum on the nymph just behind the head sort of thing. Sometimes it looks right, sometimes you don't really notice it, but for our set of legs, again just the same. Buttons. Happy with that. Snip off the waist. Try and put this round so I can show you what I'm doing. More turns in there. Then circle forward in front of the shank. Straight on. Straight on with a up finish. 4. Double needle in. There you go. Bring your thread back up. Retighten. Snip off the waist. So obviously now your legs are still far too long. So secret is don't trim them too short the first time. You can always trim them shorter, but you can never put material back on, if you know what I mean. Just trim them all roughly half the size. Then just skin. Really take your time. You want to trim it to the finished size. Be doing a new pair of scissors, I think. Doesn't need to be forever, quite happy with that. And then to finish the fly up off, get some Deer Creek resin. Take your time in this part, really. Finishes the fly off. Get your applicator. Some people use double needle, I think these are not too bad. Small amount on there. And you don't want to go to thickness, you want to keep, still keep this a nice streamlined look. What that also do is that will make your legs more secure as well, so they're not going to fall out now with that Deer Creek stuff on top of them. So I'm happy with the look of that there. Then get your torch to set the resin. And to finish the fly off, I just like to, the row of legs, I like to darten the tips of them. I think it just finishes the fly off. Really makes it really realistic looking. Just take your time. Happy with that. Sometimes I'll put a wee bit of varnish on the tail just to give them a bit of durability. But there you go, that's my version of the base nymph. Thanks for watching.